is a short one-act play. It's kind of an interesting, absurdist look at the way that we meet. All right, here we go.
English Principle, Chapter 3. The party, section 1, saying hello.
Hello!
But remember, before you begin, the first 3 minutes of conversation between two people can determine their relationship for the rest of eternity. So watch your language.
Hello.
Hi.
How are you?
Good.
I don't think I know you.
My name's Jill.
I'm Jack.
Hello.
How do you do? Oh. Friend of the host?
Friend of the hostess.
Oh, so...
Well... Nice
party!
Excellent. Well, let's look at the underlying rhythm of this energy.
Bubba beep.
Boop.
Bubba beep bop.
Ba da dee da.
Ba da doo wa. Ba da boop beep boop beep.
Ba da beep beep.
Oh. Ba. Da wa ba.
Oh, hello, hello. It's always hello.
You're the most wonderful woman at this party.
And then goodbye, goodbye.
You have a light that surrounds you.
Every time I hear the word in hello, it's like a magical incantation, an open sesame.
Hello, I say over.
Abracadabra.
My name is Jack.
And then a whole universe opens up to me, full of light.
Hello, hello.
And then goodbye, goodbye.
Section 2, the structure of English language. Fred! First name?
Mary!
First name.
Hello!
Salutation.
How are you?
Social display of affection followed by?
How are you?
Good.
Superficial question about health?
Good.
Superficial answer?
That's good.
Occupational question?
How's the job?
Terrific.
Acceptable falsehood.
So.
Nameless monosyllable to add an attempt at searching a new topic? Quite a smorgasbord. Attempt at a new topic? Meaningless noise to reject topic.
Well,
exclamation to signal the approaching end of energy.
I was in love with you once upon a time.
You asked me about my job and I lied to you.
You, who look so self-possessed and mature.
I would have answered you honestly once upon a time.
Once upon a time you would have cried upon my shoulder like a little child.
We would have talked to each other like two people who loved each other and then got home and laid in bed.
We used to go to parties like this all the time.
Together.
So happy. Well,
it was nice seeing you, Fred.
Expression of pleasure, first name.
Take care of yourself, Mary.
Parting wish, first
bye.
Name.
Bye.
Valediction. Section 3, the hidden meanings of the English language.
Well,
in this context, holy crap.
Didn't know you were here.
Wasn't 5 years enough?
How you doing, Hank?
Oh, good.
None of your freaking business.
Nice party.
Screw you, Agnes.
Very nice.
Have you tried the chicken?
Have some salmonella?
I'm sick.
I know you have problems with your mother, but you don't have to poison me.
Well, it was nice seeing you, Hank.
I'm yours.
Take care.
Screw you,
Adam. Bye.
Section 3, the arbitrariness of information.
Excuse me, I don't think I know you, but I'm Jack.
My name's Jill.
I'm Bill.
Hi.
I'm Ted.
How do you do?
Melvin. And you are?
Oh, Jill.
Oh, hello, Jill.
Monica.
How are you, Monica?
Denise.
Denise, could we have gone to college together?
Oh, I went to Stanford.
Oh!
Bennington.
Oh!
Chicago.
Excuse me, your name is?
Louise. And you are?
Barney.
So where'd you grow up, Bob?
Well...
Jim?
Well...
Stanley?
Well, I grew up in Washington.
Huh.
Santa Fe.
Great place.
St. Louis.
Nice.
How about you, Jane?
My name's Jill.
Oh, I'm sorry. Jill.
But my name could be anything.
Anyways, I went to med school.
I wasn't born with a name.
I went to law school.
I was given a name.
I was a plumber.
My name could have been easily Beth or Phyllis or Jane.
Quite a smorgasbord, isn't it?
Or Gertrude or Natasha?
You know what the problem with a smorgasbord is? There are too many choices.
A hummingbird doesn't have a name.
Do I want the roast beef or the chicken?
Fish doesn't have a name.
Pate or cheese?
A hedgehog doesn't have a name.
Yo, it's just like life that way.
It's just this handful of skin and fur and a beating heart inside of it.
You know, do I read? Do I work? Do I listen to music?
Completely anonymous.
Do I come to this party or do I...
A hedgehog doesn't even know it doesn't have a name.
You know what? I thought, you know, coming to this party would be a total waste of time, but...
With a name, you're just an example of something.
But, you know, I thought maybe I'd meet the love of my life at this party.
But I'm not an example of something.
Do you think she's here?
I'm some body.
I'm Jack.
I'm Jill.
Hello.
Section 28. The should would could.
Okay, so we meet at this park.
And we already like each other.
We like each other instantly. I'm Zeno.
Miranda, did you know that the first 3 minutes of conversation can determine your relationship to the other person for the rest of eternity?
But we passed the 3 minute mark. We meet and we mesh.
Boy, what a mesh.
And, you know, it all starts right here on this spot, you know? All things seem possible.
All things are possible.
The infinite smorgasbord lies before us. But what do we do?
Party's wrapping up.
Crowd is thinning.
But the question in the moment is...
Do I ask you out?
Do I ask you out?
And if you do, should I accept? You know, this could be one of those glorious and intoxicating meetings best left to memory.
Or the start of eternal love.
So I said, would you like to go out for coffee sometime?
Sorry, but thanks anyway.
Bye. And that's the road of no thank you.
Dead end.
But possibly a happy dead end. But down this road here is...
Would you like to get a cup of coffee sometime?
Sure.
So, we go out for coffee.
And we have a horrible time.
Dead end.
Or a wonderful time.
Meaning we get a second cup.
And we stop right there.
Dead end.
Or a third cup. And a fourth cup. And a fifth cup.
Well, we had made out by now.
Maybe we would have.
I'd say we should have.
Certainly could have.
Say we did.
And it was hard.
Dead end. Or?
It was wonderful.
Meaning we can go and we move in with each other.
Mistake.
Dead end.
Or it's wonderful.
And we get engaged.
Married.
Children.
Bliss.
And then right on to divorce.
Or the other road. Maybe we're down the road of no thank you. It took years and years before. Years and years have passed.
And then we meet each other at a party and you say,
Hi, I'm Zeno.
Miranda.
Don't I know you from somewhere?
And then a whole universe opens up in front of us.
Full of joy.
All things are possible.
It all starts right on this spot.
Should, would, could.
Well, it was nice meeting you, Miranda.
Yes, nice meeting you, Zeno.
Section 78. Say goodbye.
Listen, I only have a few minutes.
Let's practice a typical interchange.
The crowd is thinning. The party's wrapping up. Coats are disappearing from the pile on the bed.
A typical interchange, please.
I just wanted to say while I have the chance. You're the most wonderful woman at this party.
Typical, please.
On this street, in this city, in this country, on this planet.
You're the most wonderful man I've met in years.
You have a light that surrounds you.
You're intoxicating.
You're radiant. I come to this party one thing and I leave it transformed.
I came to this party to meet the love of my life.
And you're her.
You're she.
You're her. You are the love of my life.
It could be anything.
But it's Jill.
Hello, hello.
Abracadabra. I'm Jack.
Would you like to get a cup of coffee sometime, Jack?
I'd like that very much, Jill.
And it all happens right here.
A plus.
Yeah.